to round 14 from Monza. We are, of course, trying to beat Sergio Perez, who is our new rival. We want to finish in third place or higher and beat Kimi, which, obviously, the only thing I want to do here is a win for everybody here in Italy for the Prancing Horse. So I'm not even going to take long. I'm just going to jump right in. We're on pole. Let's see what we can do.
It's race day here in Italy once again. Monza, home to so many records. The smallest winning margin, for example. Do you remember in 1971, Peter Gethin beat Ronnie Peterson to the line by 1/100th of a second. There were 40 overtakes for the lead alone in 1965, and Kimi Raikkonen clocked a record top speed of 230 miles per hour here, just over a decade ago. So there's a lot to live up to then for all of our drivers today. With top speeds in excess of 220 miles per hour, few places can hope to touch Monza's crown as the fastest circuit in Formula One. Hard braking zones going into three chicanes make up the majority of the 11 corners on this 3.6 mile circuit. And just in case the slipstream wasn't enough, well, two DRS zones will help encourage some close action. It's a very tight turn one here in a very big braking zone. It's a corner, Anthony Davidson, where we've seen a number of lap one incidents in the past.
As you say, it's a very small piece of track when you have more than just one car trying to go through it. The actual run down towards the chicane is quite wide, so off the start, we'll often see drivers running two or maybe three abreast as they come up towards the braking zone. Everyone wants to brake late, of course, to win track position, and that tends to be where we see a lot of contact. And you'll see the more experienced drivers kind of hang back a little into here and focus more on picking up the pieces from other people's incidents.
You've done well to put it on pole, but we've still got work to do. Trying to cover the inside line off the start.
With that then, let's run through the grid order. It's Ferrari in pole position then, and it's Lewis Hamilton alongside. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Rosberg, Grosjean, Esteban Gutierrez, and Ricciardo, Verstappen, Raikkonen, Hülkenberg, and Sergio Perez, Sainz, Magnussen, Valtteri Bottas, and Massa, Kvyat, Alonso, Jolyon Palmer, and Felipe Nasser, Button, and Wehrlein, Rio Haryanto, and Marcus Ericsson rounds off the grid. And with lights out just moments away,
to go.
switching to an alternate strategy. Do you want to change or stick to plan A? Okay, entering lap 3 now. DRS has been enabled. Okay, copy that.
Thank you.
6.9 seconds. They're on fresh supersofts.
Pit in.
us. Complete. Go now. Confirmed. release, release. the stewards have now enabled DRS. DRS is now online.
To the end of this lap.
there's about a lap's worth of spare fuel in the car. You won't be able to run in mix 3 for long with that much, but do burn it if you need to.
From Mercedes today, that's another historic win. And I have to wonder, Anthony Davidson, just what set them apart from the competition here?
Well, the safety car completely changed the race, didn't it? It's hard to say exactly what would have happened without it, but there's no question that they came out of that situation in a good position.
And here are our podium drivers today after that excellent race. They've excelled here, as they so often do, and it's a well-deserved victory. Mercedes, then, are on top today. So then, it's time to see how this result affects the Drivers' Championship. Well, the gap at the top of the championship has been cut down after a difficult race today for our championship leader. Now then, Anthony Davidson, who was your driver of the day?
Well, Jolyon Palmer did a great job coming through the field today, so my vote goes to him.
On to the constructors then. It was a tough race for our championship leaders who lose ground at the top of the table. That's it for today's Grand Prix, and from Ant and I, it's goodbye and see you again next time.
I can't believe I'm actually saying this, but I'm extremely disappointed with that second place finish. It's words that are, I would think, would never come out of my mouth, but I'm extremely disappointed with that second place finish. That was... We had the dominant car. We were the fastest car. I mean, there's a guy sitting right there in front of me, too. It's Kimmy. Kimmy! So it looks like we do... I never noticed that, but it looks like post-race we do share this area together. And there's our main man, our main engineer, who I couldn't tell you who his name is if I wanted to. Oh, God. But second place, just, like I said, just not what... what I was hoping for, really, out of it. And we'll do chassis weight. And then, of course, with Singapore up next, That'll be our last one, and we'll get the drag done, and that will set us through to the end of the season, and we'll see what we can do there. But that's it's disheartening to know that we had the car. We opened up like a 9-second lead through the first stint, and it was all wiped out by Alonso. I mean, I dove up to his inside, but I mean, come on, there's got to be something there where they break out of it. He just turns right into the pits, and I tried so hard to avoid it, and there was just nothing, and I end up coming onto pit road unintentionally, and I have to put on the medium tires, and it just didn't go well there at that point at all.
Hi, how are you today? The improved package has arrived. We're having it fitted in time for FP1. Have a look at the factory report.
All right, so we have chassis weight now put on the car to make us a little more, what I was trying to say is we're trying to skinny up the car. Jesus Christ. I could not say that to save my damn life. But yeah, we're trying to make the car a little skinnier. Make her weigh a little less. So that's the key there. And we'll move on to free practice one here in Singapore. And like I said, let me see here if I can see what I'm doing. I can go ahead and cease R&D. We're going to actually wait until the race is over, and then we're going to make our decision on what we're going to actually upgrade and what we're not going to upgrade. Everything was looking so well, though, in Monza. We had the perfect weekend. We went P1 in free practice 1 and continued to do so in free practice 2 and free practice 3, P1 in all of the practice sessions. We went P1 in all three of the qualifyings, and we rolled off on first, and we just got home just short. So we're gonna try to improve that here this week. And as you can see, Lewis Hamilton is losing ground. He's not fared well the last couple races, so my immediate goal is to try to gain on Ricardo. I highly doubt that's going to happen, as the Red Bulls are extremely good. That last race was just weird. That was a weird race in general. So either way, thanks, Scott, ladies and gentlemen, for joining us here in... Thanks for joining us. It's been disheartening, to say the least, with that result. But we'll move on to Singapore, and hopefully we'll be a little bit faster. So thanks, guys, for joining us. And until next time, just keep it cool.